Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today I had another awesome question just come in. It's the day of amazing questions from doctors. Anytime I get a question I don't have a video on, I try to make content around it so that someone else can find that question next time, or if I don't have time to answer it, I can send you guys the video with the answer. So that's why I have 7,000 videos. It just makes my life easier. But in any case, the question today was, there was a case that came in, I was talking to the doctor about it. It was like a patient had like a Sagittal Schwartz. And if you don't know what the difference between a Sagittal and a Schwartz or a Sagittal Schwartz, you need to watch all my videos on these topics. I have dozens and dozens and possibly up to 50 to 100. I don't know, I have a lot. I think at last I checked, I have 177 phase one interceptive videos. So you need to watch those videos first if you don't know what this is, because this video is not going to make any sense otherwise. So to watch those videos, go to my YouTube channel, Straight Smile Solutions. It has a green banner. From there, you scroll down to the homepage. Second one down is the phase one interceptive playlist. There's 177 plus videos to date. Find all the ones on Sagittals and Schwartzes. Or if you want to search by keyword, if you go to my YouTube channel again, go to the little magnifying glass, top right, and put in Sagittal, S-A-G-I-T-T-A-L. Ooh, I spelt it right here. I always spell it wrong. Or, oh, I spelled Schwartz wrong. Schwartz, S-C-H-W-A-R-T-Z. Sorry, you guys get the idea. Put in those keywords so you can know what they are, everything about it. All right, I'm gonna assume you know what they are. I'm gonna assume you know what a Sagittal Schwartz appliance is. And by the way, this photo is not of a Sagittal Schwartz. It is a photo of just a lower Schwartz. But I don't have one I can share on a Sagittal Schwartz with permission to share. So, but in anyways, three screw Sagittal, AKA one transverse screw for the Schwartz, two screws to advance the premaxilla. There's anterior and posterior three screw Schwartz. We're talking about an anterior three screw Schwartz. So anyways, so this is just for visualization of an appliance, for example, but I'm specifically talking about a anterior three screw Sagittal or an anterior three screw Sagittal Schwartz. Okay, so appliance wasn't fitting. So, and the clasps, these Adams claspy things or whatever clasp they were, they had broken on one side. The doctor was like, hey, we're gonna have our lab guy just solder it back. And I was like, well, wait. Clasps shouldn't be breaking. So anytime a clasp breaks, I mean, unless it broke like day one, you know, and then you got to wonder if it was overheated or over soldered or something like that, there's probably a problem with the appliance. So let's back it up and let's see what's going on. Let's look at the pictures of the appliance in the mouth. Appliance clearly wasn't fitting. It was rocking, it was bouncing. You could tell one side was up and then the other side was up. So by resoldering the clasp, we're not fixing the problem. All that's gonna happen is the problem's gonna happen again. We don't wanna be turning appliances that aren't seating. Why? Well, first of all, they're rocking. Rocking can cause pain, discomfort, periodontal problems. It can also damage teeth, damage gums, I mean, lots of things. But also the turns aren't gonna be, first of all, you know the patient's not gonna wear it if it's rocking. And it might not be actively rocking, but if it's not seated fully down the way it was meant to be, the forces don't go the way they're meant to be. And weird things are gonna happen. I don't know, canting, tipping, I'm not sure exactly what's gonna happen because I'm not trained on ill-fitting appliances. I'm only trained on properly fitting appliances. All I know is if something's not seating right and you keep turning it, you're gonna get a weird outcome that is gonna be very hard to fix later and possibly permanent. So we don't wanna keep turning, right? So I told the doctor we have one of two different things. Either you can back it up, you know, with the screw until you get it fully seated again, and we'll keep going with our turns. In that case, let's reevaluate once you get it seated. Or you can put the patient in a temporary in-house ASICs that you can make yourself, like immediately. I want the patient going home with something that fits, doesn't rock, okay? And then you can remake the appliance. So that is the story. And this type of ill-fitting or rocking and clasp breakage is a hallmark of a patient that's not wearing it full-time. That's just what happens. If you don't wear it full-time, this is what's gonna happen. I can tell, okay? Unless, you know, when you delivered it, if you didn't deliver it properly. But that's why I always recommend you take pictures whenever you deliver any appliance. Take pictures every time they come in, because you, sometimes patients, you know, and parents are like, well, this never fit. Well, yeah, it did, because I have a picture of it. Because if and when later something weird did happen, or there was a weird outcome, or the patient, this has happened to me before, so let me tell you, patient whatever reasons, decides to transfer to another provider. Maybe they're unsatisfied with you. Maybe they just don't like your prices. Maybe they don't like your hours. Maybe they moved. Other providers like, hey, this appliance isn't fitting. And it can get reported and get back to you as trouble, or get back to the dental board, or get back to the insurance company. And if you don't have that picture showing it fits, well, guess who's paying for it? It's you. So that's why we have documentation showing things fit. And nowadays, it is so easy to find HIPAA-compliant ways to take photos. It's so fast. You don't have to have fancy DSLR cameras. You just need to have HIPAA-compliant ways to take photos. And I've got videos on that. Or contact somebody who knows a lot about photos. That is, like, I'm pretty good with photos, but I'm not, like, the official photo, ortho photo person out there. So, but I definitely can give you resources to help you out. So anyways, long story short, hopefully this doctor did what was recommended and either got the appliance to fit again and kept turning, or remade the appliance. And the moral of the story is, you need to make sure your patients know, accountability loop, that they gotta wear their appliances full time. We will find out if they're not wearing it full time. And full time means 22 to 24 hours a day. If they think they're gonna have an issue with popping it out at school and not putting it back in, or if they play a ton of sports, it might be a better idea to have a fixed appliance instead of a removable. All right, thank you.